Hello and welcome to Frost Over the World. Later in the programme, I'll be talking to Hollywood star and writer Gene Wilder. I'll also be joined by Iraq's former defence minister, Ali Alawi, and we'll be taking a look at this week's elections in Algeria. But first, let's turn to the crisis in Gaza. During the past week, over 40 people have been killed in internal fighting between the two main Palestinian factions, Hamas and Fatah. Now, in the last 2 days, Israel has re-entered the equation. They were never very far away, but by bombing Hamas targets in Gaza, which they blame for the rockets that were fired by Hamas into Israel. Joining me from the Dead Sea in Jordan is the Information Minister of the Palestinian National Unity Government, Mustafa Barghouti. Welcome, Mr. Barghouti. We're delighted you're with us.
Thank you, sir. I'm pleased to be with you.
Thank you. Beginning with, come back to the basic Palestinian dispute, but starting with today's news, and here's one headline from The Guardian Online, Israeli airstrikes, that was yesterday and today, Israeli airstrikes killed 10 in Gaza. Does this change the situation, or is the basic dispute still the same and Israel are always a cloud on the horizon?
Well, it doesn't change the situation as much as it confirms the reality of the situation, which is that all of us, the Palestinians, are under Israeli occupation still, whether we are in the West Bank or in Gaza Strip, and that we are all, the Palestinians, all of us, are the victims and targets of the Israeli aggression. As you said, today there were attacks that took the lives of 10 people. Yesterday there were attacks that took the lives of 7 other people. In general, since this government was established, Israel killed no less than 45 Palestinians, while no Israelis were killed. And to us, this Israeli attack is a reminder that we should all be united and we should put aside our internal differences. But also it's a reminder that this is the real Israeli response to our 4 initiatives, the initiative for prisoners exchange, the Arab Peace Initiative for a holistic peace, and our initiative for complete, comprehensive, and reciprocal ceasefire. This Israeli attack is practically the response to all these initiatives, and it shows there is no Israeli partner for peace at the moment. I'm very sad to say so.
At the same time, I suppose when Israel has said Hamas fired more than 100 rockets in the last few days into Israel, and we will respond if that continues. I mean, that was not a very wise move.
Well, if they want to stop the missiles, the road is very simple. We've done that already in November, and we're offering them complete Palestinian total abstention from any form of violence, both in West Bank and Gaza, in return for Israelis complete and total abstention from any form of violence, both in West Bank and Gaza. We're offering absolute and complete total elimination of violence. They are responding with attacks. They have rejected constantly for the last 2 months our offer for mutual and reciprocal ceasefire. What they want is unilateral abstention of any form of resistance from the Palestinian side, while Israel continues invading Palestinian cities, killing Palestinians, assassinating people. During the last 2 months, there were many missiles, you are right, but not a single Israeli was killed, not a single one. During the same period of time, as I said, 45 Palestinians were killed, including many women, many children. At least 7 children were killed in the Israeli attacks.
And at the same time, let's just come back a day or two to the thing we thought we would be talking about first, which is the dispute that's going on between the two Palestinian forces in Gaza. You said on one occasion that if the two parties wanted to sort this out, they could. Why don't they? What do they have to do to sort out this very damaging battle with, again, more deaths?
I think there are 3 reasons, and I'll explain them very quickly, since I think I know why. I have been the mediator between them for a long time, and recently in the last agreement 2 days ago. The main first reason is that each side still think they can dominate and run the Palestinian show alone. which is impossible. We are now a democracy. No single party can single-handedly and alone run the Palestinian life. They have to accept the rule of democracy. The second reason is this prevalence of a terrible, violent culture, and that where people think that by using violence they can impose what they think. And here there is a serious handicap which we have to work on, because some people on both sides, on both factions, still think that democracy is not the way. I believe there is nothing wrong with pluralism, with having differences. What is wrong is to try to solve these differences in a violent way and in an undemocratic and unpeaceful and nonviolent way, and in a violent way. My last point is that there are lots of external interventions in the Palestinian issue. Regional interventions, international interventions. There are countries in the world that try to supply us with more weapons, that want us to have more security forces, although we already have 90,000 people in the security apparatus. This is so large that we can enter Guinness record for being the only country in the world where the number of people employed in the security apparatus is larger than the whole public and civil sector. This large security apparatus is consuming 32% of our budget, 44% of the salaries of the Palestinian Authority, and these same security forces are divided and shooting each other. There has to be a complete and total reform. What we need from the world community is not more weapons, is not more guns, is not more incitement so that Palestinians would kill each other. What we need is money for health, for education, for infrastructure. What we need is to lift this embargo that is killing us and driving 90% of the people under the line of poverty. 9 out of every 10 families in Gaza live below the line of poverty. That's why there is so much violence. What we need is to lift the embargo, allow health to develop, provide humanitarian needs for Palestinians, allow development to take place. What is happening is that many forces outside are trying to use the Palestinian issue for their own regional or international interest.
And in terms of the dispute that we've seen in the last few days and the disputes between Fatah and Hamas, and you, I know, are effectively, you're there in the cabinet as an independent figure, not particularly Hamas, not particularly Fatah. What we've seen the last four truces going down, failing in the last few days, would you say that Hamas and Fatah are exactly equally responsible for that? Or is one a bit more responsible than the other?
Well, I don't have the way to measure that, but to be honest with you, during the last dispute in general, I think both sides are responsible. It's not important if one side is responsible 51% and the other side is 49%. Both are responsible and both must respond to our calls to end this terrible dispute and accept the rules of democracy to organize our differences. There is no way but to keep democracy. There is no way but to resort to democratic, nonviolent means. And we are working on that, and I hope we will succeed. But at the end of the day, life has also shown how important and it is for Palestinians to have also a third democratic force in Palestine that is independent from both Hamas and Fatah, because this terrible polarization, if continues, could destroy our future. We are a learning, a young democracy, but the future is ahead of us. And I hope these disputes will stop immediately, and people will learn through experience that when they make a democratic choice, when they put a paper in the ballot box, they decide what happens to them in every aspect of life. It's a great experience if, hopefully, we manage to kill it, we manage to stop this violence, we manage to stop this dispute as soon as possible.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. We lose the satellite in a moment. One last question, a brief answer. How long will it be before you think you will see a viable, independent Palestinian state?
When the world community understands that Israel has created an apartheid system, as President Jimmy Carter said, worse than the apartheid system in South Africa, and when the world decides to pressure Israel to end the occupation, which has become 40 years, and to end the suffering of the Palestinian people, which is going to be 60 years next year.
Thank you very much indeed for joining us. We really appreciate it. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Our great thanks there, and to our team there who got the pictures back to us there. Join me after the break when I'll be meeting Iraq's former defense minister, Ali Alawi.